Hi everyone, hope that you are well. So today I want to work together on inserting lighting calculation surface, for example, for an office room. And I will start with planning the room. So I don't have anything planned this time. I will start this example by defining the length of the room. Let's say 5 meters length, then we go for a width of, let's say 4 meters, and we put a height, which is typical for an office, 2.7, can remain also 3 meters, but I would say I would prefer to go on 2.7. Wall thickness 0.2, so that would be okay. We have also the space for here. From here you can change or choose the space that you want to design the lighting. So, and you see office, I would just let offices. So here we have the application related to the office. I will go for, let's say, yeah, just CAD workplaces. Let's go like this and then just click OK. And now we'll have the space in a couple of seconds. Open in Dialux. So yeah, this is the space that we have configured for the office. On the name, we can just say office 1, for example. Then we have the story height 2.7. and the floor thickness. So that's the visualization 2D. If you want to have a look on the 3D, yeah, you can see the office. Then on the room side, here we have the room, and I will go back to the 2D. If you want to change as well to check the height of the work plan, it's 0.8. The wall zone being an office, I will exclude the 0.5, let's say, from the calculation point of view, but you can let as well 0 if we don't have any furniture. Usually because we have furniture on the near the walls, then we need, it's I would advise to exclude that area because we don't need light upon the shelves. Room here again. Office, and then we have already pre-selected the space and the application, and we see the visual is 500 lux, surrounding 300, background 100. You need a uniformity 0.6, and then we go on the height of working plan, it's 0.8. good, so we have everything established. I will say the next step to not let the to have an empty room, I will go on, let's say we will just add some furniture. For example, I want to have a desk. We just drag and drop. I will just rotate it. It is quite a big desk actually. I want from something smaller, but yeah, it's good. I'll just place it one desk here. Let's see how it looks. Yeah, I will just copy the same desk on the other part. So we have two desks, I would say, for this small office. I tried to place it in the middle just to have it, yeah, have a look. We should actually rotate this one with the drawers to the user. So I will just do that. Okay, and it's good to see it. I will propose also to the IT systems. Next, let's add also chairs, what we need for the for the office. So yeah, I'll take this chair, place it there. I think we need to rotate it as well. I think this should be the right. Let's see the 3D. Yeah, that's the right position. Once again, we copy on the underside and then I'll just rotate it. The main purpose, as I said, is to insert calculation surfaces. We'll have a comparison. I will use for the right side, a different lighting solution, and we add here a calculation surface. For the left side, we will use a different luminaire, and we'll add also here calculation surface. And I want also to add a calculation surface in the middle, and just to see the difference that we have when we run the lighting calculation related to the illuminance level on all three, let's say, calculation surfaces. And also, if you never use calculation surface, I think it will be good to know how to insert it and how to use, how to set up the height, and how to define also the dimension of a calculation surface. So good, now we have some, let's say, furniture added in the office. I will place also some windows on the other side. So then I will just go here. Just let's see if I drag and drop on the office side. I will place it again. Yeah, one window on this side. Of course, here you can change also the dimensions, but in this case, I will just, yeah, copy to have a symmetry, let's say, and yeah, it looks like this, to have also some daylight. Usually daylight in the office, good to have, and normally we have a port of natural light for the off in an office application. And then just drag and drop, we can place also a door. Yeah, it's there. So everything looks okay. It's a little bit small office, I would say, but for two desks, I would say 20 square meters, it's more than enough. Okay, now that we have defined, we place some furniture. We have also we can use also some colors. Let's use a little bit of color to not let everything gray. So let's say we jump into material, for example. You go indoor. We can choose, for example, for the tiles. It's not really for the office. Let's go for some painted wood, so yeah, it looks a little bit better. And let's choose now a color as well for the walls. I will say, let's use this one, ash light gray. Of course, it's up to you, and let's use the same, I'll say, color. I use this also for the ceiling. And yeah, here you go. So that's very fast how we can also build a space by using Dialux Evo. And now let's jump to establish the calculation surface. Here we have the calculation objects. So we have this one usually. I'm using the rectangular calculation, so I would just, it's easy. I would just go above the first desk. So we go like this. So we have it configured. Only be careful, because if you don't establish the height, you see it's placing on the floor level, and we have seen that the setup of the measurement of the illuminance is on 8.8 meters above the lighting. So here you can just set up again the 0.8, And then you see it's already established on different level. The next way we'll place the same on the other side. So we can copy, or we can just, I'll just draw it once again. Same procedure, and then just put on 0.8 above, and you should see it also here. And now, as I said, I will place one in the middle, or we can place one here, for example. Now I will say near the window. I will just scale it a little bit, yeah, something like that. We can also copy the same, place it here, and this we can say like surrounding area. And also I will say let's place it 0.8, same this one. So basically you'll, by placing this lighting calculation surface, you can know exactly the level of the illuminance on different, let's say, parts of the room. So now you see we have like five calculation surfaces all around the space. And now is the time to select the luminaires and just add it to the space. Yeah. So here I would just use something from my library, which I really use. Of course, you need to use luminaires which are suitable for or complying with the office. So for the first one, I will just use a freestanding luminaire. You can see it in the 3D how it's looking. And for the second desk, I will just use two recessed luminaires. I will go for this one, for example, and then you can just draw a line arrangement. And you see, I will just place, I think I want to place two, to be honest, just one. It doesn't look so nice. So here I'll just place two luminaires. So this is more about to have a perception of using different lighting fixtures and how the light is dissipating in the room, and also on different calculation surface, what's the impact. And I start the calculation, let's see the outcome. It's not more about to have the 500 lux, it's just to get a perception how easily you can insert the calculation surface in your space and get the results and interpret the results on those calculation surfaces. So it will take a little bit of time. As we have inserted more calculation surface, it will take a little bit longer. But in inserting calculation surfaces on the project, it gives you the advantage that you are more accurate on the lighting levels that you have in that room and the space. And as well, also how to, which type of luminaire you can choose and which light distribution curve you should use for that application. We'll wait for the results, and then we'll dive in together to check the light output for each desk area and also the uniformity. Meanwhile, if you like the video, if you find interesting, please subscribe to my channel if you didn't do it yet. As well, like the video, share with your friends which are working in the lighting industry. I would appreciate that. And if you have questions, just insert your comments below this video. And yeah, check the other videos which I made already. I think they are interesting, and share your opinion with me. Appreciate it. Yeah, it takes longer than expected, to be honest. I was thinking that the calculation run faster, but yeah, it takes some time. And an additional thing, I think it's very good also to try to use floor texture colors when you do the lighting design. So because then you obtain more accurate information, I would say. So here we go. We have the results, and now I will just go on this, and we should see. So on the calculation number one, I will just click. We have 596, and yeah, that's a lot. So that we have achieved the 500. Calculation number two, we have 523, and also deformity 0.44 in the case number two, and 0.1989. Then if you move on the calculation number three near the window, we have 514. That's a lot. But if you move on the calculation surface number four, you see we have only 290. So that's a little bit big difference to related to the other values. And five in the middle between the two desks, we have 472. And overall in the space we have 495 and 0.32. So here we need actually, and say also with red, we will need an additional light source to obtain 500 lux level, and I think the uniformity should be 0.6. but as mentioned, this video is more about how to insert calculation objects and how to use it, how to interpret it when you do a lighting simulation. So once again, if you like this video, subscribe to my channel and give a like. I wish you a good day. Take care of you. So until next time, all the best. Bye bye.